Good morning, everyone. My name is Lokesh. I'll be dealing with the topic called rational numbers. So before I get into this topic called rational numbers, I'll take a quick review of the collection of numbers which we have discussed earlier. So we start with the first collection of numbers, which is your natural numbers. So we denote natural numbers with n, and these are the numbers 1, 2, 3, and so on. Next, the next collection of numbers which we have discussed after this collection is your whole numbers. So this collection is formed by joining 0 to the set of natural numbers. So these are your 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. Now, after this, we have gone with the next set of collection of numbers. Those are called your integers, which we denote with z or I. And these are the combination of the collection of negative numbers and whole numbers, so which we write like 0, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, and so on. Now these are the kinds of numbers which we have discussed till now, that is natural numbers, whole numbers, then integers. Now let us consider this situation. Suppose say you have a cake, say this is your cake, and you need to consume this cake for 4 days in equal quantities. So generally what we do is we divide this cake into 4 equal parts. So these are your 4 equal parts, and you will consume each part in each day. So that is generally what we do. Now if you consider this part, now this part is one part out of all the 4 parts. Now this is same, like one part out of 4 parts. This is again one part out of 4 parts, one part out of 4 parts. Suppose say there is an exam which is for 25 marks, and you have scored say 24, then generally we write that 24 on 25. That is, you have scored 24 marks out of 25, just like the same. This is one part out of the 4 parts, therefore we represent this as 1 by 4. Like the same, this is also 1 by 4, 1 by 4. And 1 by 4. So at the end of the second day, you might have consumed 2 parts of it. So that is 2 parts out of 4 parts. End of the third day, you might have consumed 3 parts. That is 3 parts out of 4 parts. Now these are also the numbers which you are familiar with, and these are what we call them as fractions. So till now these are the known numbers. That is your natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, and fractions. These are the numbers which are familiar to you. Now suppose say there are 2 illustrations. Say one is Shimla, the other one say Nainital. Say the temperature of Shimla is some minus 5 degrees at a given day in a winter season. And if suppose say the temperature of Nainital is half the temperature of Shimla, then the temperature of Nainital would have been minus 5 by 2 degrees Celsius. Now this is a number which we have not dealt with earlier. This is not a natural number, this is not a whole number, this is not an integer, but it has got a close relation with a fraction. Now if you disregard this negative sign, now this number is same as the fractions. So now if we put these fractions and these fraction like numbers, both the collections, into a single collection, and such kind of collection we call them as rational numbers. That is, the collection of all fractions together with fraction like numbers like minus 5 by 2 say, minus 3 by 2, minus 7 by 6, you know, these are very much closer to fractions except the signs. Here you are only talking about a positive sign, whereas here we include a negative sign. So both resembles the same, however there is an exception with regards to the sign. Now such kind of collection we call them as rational numbers. Now what we do is we try to come across a general form for all these rational numbers. That is a form which fits for all the numbers. So these are your numbers 2 by 7. Now this is the collection of which I am going about, 2 by minus 2 by 7, 5 by 2, minus 3 by 5, some minus 7 by 6, 3 by some or say some 8 and so on. So this is your collection. Now we examine closely these rational numbers. Now if you observe, now all the top parts of these numbers, which we call them as numerators, they are all integers. Now 3 is an integer, minus 2 is an integer, 5 is an integer, minus 3 is an integer, minus 7 is an integer. So all the numbers in the numerator position are integers. So what I do is, for all the integers, I'll take a symbol called P. And I'll say that P takes all the integers as we may place today. And similarly, if you look into all the denominators, again all the denominators are integers. So to make a clear distinction between a numerator and denominator, I take another symbol called Q. Again, Q takes all the integers as we may place today. So P is an integer, Q is an integer, and P by Q, now we call it as a rational number, because all the rational numbers can be generated from P by Q. Per se, minus 7 by 2. Now to generate minus 7 by 2, now P should be minus 7, Q should be 2. Of that matter, if you take any rational number, per se minus 7 by 6. Now take P as minus 6, or in fact P as minus 7 and Q as 6, then we can generate minus 7 by 6. Similarly, P as minus 3, Q as 5, you can generate this. P as 5, Q as 2, you can generate this. And like the same, you can generate all the rational numbers using the form P by Q. Hence we say that P by Q is the general form of a rational number, where P is an integer and Q is an integer. Now what if Q is 0? Now say you have some chocolates. So in the case of chocolates, then you have the persons to distribute, and say the number of chocolates each person receives. So this is the case. Suppose say you have some 10 chocolates and there are 10 persons to distribute. Therefore each person will receive one chocolate. If suppose again we have the same quantity of chocolates, you have 5 persons to distribute, then each person will get 2 chocolates. Again, if there are 10 persons, in fact 10 chocolates, 2 persons to distribute, then each person will get 5 chocolates. Again, if there are 10 chocolates, there is only 1 person to distribute, then you can have 10 chocolates to be distributed for that particular person, or that particular person may get 10 chocolates. Now we suppose say there are 10 chocolates and 0 persons, and assume that 0 is a particular number of persons, so 0 is a person, and now you have 10 chocolates to distribute. Now if you observe the pattern, when the number of persons are being reduced, the number of chocolates each person receives keeps increasing. Therefore, when the number of persons becomes 0, then the chocolates as per this pattern should be increasing. But this is inappropriate, because the number of chocolates remains constant. It cannot be more than 10, or it cannot be equivalent to 10. So when you consider this division by 0, we are coming across some inappropriate conclusions. So we take that division by 0 as undefined. That is, we don't allow Q to be 0 to avoid these kind of inappropriate conclusions. Therefore, P can take any integers, Q can take any integer. However, Q is not equivalent to 0. To avoid this kind of inappropriate conclusions. Now what if Q, can Q be 0? Or in fact, can P be 0? Of course, P be 0, because if P is 0, then Q can be any other number. 0 by 2, 0 by 2 is again a 0, then this is your rational number. So P can be 0, however, Q cannot be 0. Therefore, a rational number is any number of the form P by Q, where Q not equal to 0. And P and Q are integers. And this is what we take the definition of a rational number. That is, any number which can be written of the form P by Q, Q not equal to 0, and P and Q are integers, we call such kind of numbers as a rational number, and we call it as the general form of a rational number, because this fits for all the rational numbers, that any rational number can be generated using the form P by Q by giving any value for P and Q. Any value in the sense, so any integer can be taken for P and Q.